body language.
Is that right?
Have they had to?
Go right for the new girl. Let me see.
Don't you come with any signing up the floor.
She's saying you come for
it. That's wonderful.
Isn't it nice? Oh, Sandra, you were so smart to bring that. That is great.
Yeah. Mm.
And they have a sculpture of her.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Franklin Jennifer, president of the university, and Mrs. Jennifer. Dr. Joyce Ladner, Vice President for Dr. Jeff Donaldson, Dean of the College of Fine Arts, and the Howard University-wide Cultural Committee Project. I welcome you to this special luncheon, honoring one of our own, Dr. Pearl Primus. College of Fine Arts with the dance unit of the college is indeed a rare and unique occurrence for our students and the metropolitan community. A pioneer in the fields of dance, choreography, anthropology, and education, Dr. Primus has been rightly called, quote, the world's foremost authority on African dance, and the mother of African-American dance. Both titles, I think, are essential appellations for one who has given so much of herself, of her talents, and of her intellect to this field. As choreographer and dancer, Dr. Primus studied modern dance techniques with other American pioneers, and testimony of this dedication materialized in 1991 when she received the President's National Medal of Arts. Dr. Primus was one of the first Black artists to explore her African heritage and to create concerts, works in the modern dance idiom using themes of African-American experience. It is therefore with great pleasure that I join the President of the University, the Vice President for Academic Affairs, the Dean of the College, and the cultural-wide community, as well as the institutional, the Office for Institutional Development, rather, in paying tribute to Dr. Pearl Primus in this luncheon. I think that her residency represents a first-time residency, offering first-hand knowledge of a living and important stimulus for our students and other participants in understanding the aesthetics of dance and its importance. Later in the program, my colleague and friend, Dr. Sherelle Berman Miller, who herself is a stalwart in the field of dance, she came to the College of Fine Arts in September 1991, when, as a recommendation of Howard 2000, the dance unit was transferred to the College of Fine Arts from the College of Arts and Sciences. And since a year ago, we have worked assiduously in restructuring the dance program so that it reflects the fine art form that it is. We are very optimistic that the college's proposals to offer a BFA and a BA in dance will be approved for the fall of 1993. Dr. Berman Miller and her colleagues in the dance unit have worked to see that this takes place. And particularly, Dr. Berman Miller has, through her initiative and aggressiveness in proposal writing, that this project with Dr. Primus's residency was funded by the Lila Wallace Reader's Digest Arts Partners Program. And Dr. Miller later will give us an overview and insights into Dr. Primus's residency. But once again, I'd like to welcome you, patrons of the arts, art enthusiasts, to Howard University and to a luncheon for Dr. Pearl Primus. This feast and the gathering here of kindred spirits say in general, we love you. Thank you again. Welcome. Much luncheon will be served immediately, and the program will proceed as printed.
This company is for you. Their food is so wonderful.
All right.
Oh, my, yes. Always. And their desserts are even better.
Oh, right.
Semester residency involves students from Howard University, American University, and community artists in technique classes and residency study with Dr. Primus. This is in preparation for a major stage performance production at Crampton Auditorium, Howard University, and the Terrace Theater, Kennedy Center. It is also giving the opportunity for outreach activities and lecture demonstrations to various age groups, including senior citizens from the Senior Citizen Counseling and Delivery Service on Martin Luther King Avenue Southeast. This project will be the first to document her working process as an artist, as well as a concert performance featuring her seldom seen works by populations outside of the dance world of Jacob's Pillow in the American Dance Festival. Dr. Primus is a well-known anthropologist whose work as a dancer and choreographer brings her fame with such pieces as The Negro Speaks of Rivers, Dance of Strength, and Strange Fruit. Dr. Primus is the 1991 American Dance Festival Chair for Distinguished Teachers, as well as several National Endowment for the Arts grants and numerous other awards and honors. In 1993, Dr. Primus will be celebrating 50 years of dance, and we are fortunate to be a stepping stone in this glorious event. I introduce to you Dr. Pearl Primus.
Presenters, you know how I feel about you. Though I did come with fire in my eyes last year.
Dr. Jennifer, who was represented so beautifully by Dr. Benjamin, and who is responsible for this luncheon, Delilah Wallace, Reader's Digest. Foundation, of course. All the beautiful ladies that I saw here from the various embassies, ambassadors, and wives of ambassadors, I just want to say, as we would say in Nigeria, Kabo. Kabo means welcome. I'm supposed to speak for about 10 minutes, I'm told. Which is a little on the ridiculous side. Because anyone who knows me knows that it takes me just about that long to say good afternoon. But I'll try my best. I'm happy about this grant. I'm happy for many reasons. One, it brings together people who never knew the other person or the person next to them existed. We have people in the project from the community, people from American University, people from Howard University. Not only as the performers, but we have such persons as Kim Bears, who is the lead dancer at Fildanco, and who has just received the Bessie. The Bessie in dance is the top award, or the top recognition for the year. Kim Bears, who will be dancing the Negro Speaks of Rivers. We have Linda Spriggs, who was an outstanding, in fact, she was one of the top soloists with the Albanelli Dance Company. And she will be dancing the Griot. We have, of course, Sharon, who's come up from Barbados to assist me, and who you will see in many of the dances. Onwin, who sometimes doesn't get his share of recognition because I'm the mother. And but Onwin, whose lighting and music has been acclaimed in the New York Times for dances with that I've choreographed with the Ailey Company, and who has his own little company that he works with in music. That's Onwin Dorn. Coming up from North Carolina are two outstanding people, one who's working with Chuck Davis as a musician, and the other who is the one of the assistants with the Board of Education, who is going to be Onwin's assistant. So we have quite a group working together. I have to thank the National Endowment, because as I was going over the program, it dawned on me. Now, I never planned it this way, you understand? But it dawned on me that all the dances have been reconstructed, all constructed, with a Choreographer's Fellowship grant. And, I mean, that says something. It says that here is an artist, an American artist, supported by an American association. And without that support, there could not have been these dances either reproduced or choreographed. When you come to the concert, it may not be as smooth as I would like it or anything of the kind, but you'll see the effort of people, young people, some of them 4 years old, who have come together to really make this a success. What does it really mean? It means that something is getting out there. Why is it that only now the work is being documented? And you know what I'm learning? If you have a beautiful bouquet of flowers from last year, and it was beautiful, etc., why bother keeping it and let the petals fall off or trying to reproduce it? Either you go out and pick new flowers and present them in your little vase, but I'm not so sure whether one should turn the clock back to not only speak of certain times, but to get oneself locked in the past. I intend to move on. I intend to move on doing certain things. For instance, now I'm working on a play. The play will be the culmination of my research throughout the continent of Africa. My work in the Caribbean, what I learned in Israel, Mexico, etc. And I'm very excited about that. I was excited last night when a woman called Ann Williams, Miss Ann Williams, called from Dallas, Texas. She said, "You know what?" And she said, "We have to have that project that you're doing at Howard here." And we are going to speak to the presenters, give me the name of the person who has worked it out at Howard University, et cetera, et cetera. And we will try and see if we can get Alila Wallace, Reader's Digest Foundation grant. And I stopped and thought, it's reaching out there. And it's not reaching out there because of a technique. We are insisting on discipline, etc. But there's also spirituality. And I was thrilled to read the citation from the NEA through President Bush that it was for the spirituality of the work that this grant was given. I want to thank you all for coming. Each one of you, even if I don't know you, even if I forget your name, each one has made an impression on me. Each one of you will give me the strength to continue this work. Thank you.
Yes.
Celebrating 50 years of dance and her residency here in the College of Fine Arts. We thank you all for coming, artists, the artists' patrons, the sponsors, and also for the life and the artistry of Dr. Pearl Primus, who indeed, not only through her educational pursuits and her quest for advancing the aesthetic recognition of dance and its importance in the fine arts, or the realm of fine arts. We wish to say again, we applaud your efforts and we applaud you in the longevity of your dedication and of your commitment to the arts. Could you join me rather in awarding her another round of applause?
Right here, you gotta go get this one. You don't know how much you'll bless children. Me and New York would die to be at the YMCA to take a class.